In 2018, Russian President Vladimir Putin announced that Russia was developing a series of new weapons, and Zircon was one of them. Reports have emerged that the hypersonic missile has been used against Ukraine. They were launched from land-based missile systems in Crimea. President Putin had said, according to a report from the state media agency TASS, "It has no analogues in any country in the world. I am sure that such powerful weapons will reliably protect Russia from potential external threats and will help ensure the national interests of our country. It's one of the most advanced weapons available to Russia. But as with many Russian weapons, Zircon is not living up to the hype." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the Russian Zircon hypersonic missile seems underwhelming. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. M22 Zircon is designated as SSN-33 by NATO. As per President Putin's address at the Russian Federal Assembly, the Zircon is capable of reaching speeds of Mach 9. Speed is its USP. While there are several ways to achieve hypersonic speed, Zircon is thought to use a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. It relies on the huge pressures created by fast airflow into the engine to ignite the fuel and generate thrust. President Putin mentioned that the missile is able to destroy both seagoing and land targets. As per reports, the Zircon will have both a radar target seeker and an optical electronic complex to detect and track targets. The missile could be equipped with a high explosive warhead or even a tactical nuclear warhead. On November 3, 2022, TASS announced the design and manufacture of a prototype mobile ground vehicle launcher for the Zircon as part of a coastal defense missile system. This ground-based launch platform seems to have been used for the attack on Ukraine. Importantly, on December 23, 2022, Defense Minister Sergei Shoigu announced that Admiral Gorshkov's frigate was armed with a batch of Zircon missiles. Let's check the three issues one by one. Ukrainian air defense claims to have successfully intercepted 2 hypersonic missiles. The reports went on to add that the missiles covered the distance of 360 miles or 580 kilometers to Kyiv within 3 minutes, which indicates a hypersonic flight speed. Speed was actually more than Mach 9. Ukrainian Air Force Command stated, "At about 10:30 a.m., the Russian troops attacked Kyiv with 2 ballistic missiles from the temporarily occupied Crimea. The targets were destroyed. The type is being identified." The post was attributed to Ukraine's commander of the Air Force, Lieutenant Colonel Nikola Oleshuk. The missile debris fell after being intercepted and damaged several buildings in the Pechersk district of Kyiv. Examination revealed it was a Zircon. Reports indicate that either American Patriot or German Iris-T intercepted the missile. So the missile, in spite of having such high speed, can be intercepted by currently available air defense. Other than speed, Zircon was reported to have a special trick up its sleeve, the plasma cloud. As per multiple reports, the air pressure in front of the weapon forms a plasma cloud as it moves and is completely covered by plasma cloud during the flight. Plasma cloud would absorb radio frequencies emitted from radars, and since the waves are not reflected back, It will essentially mean that the missile will be partly invisible. It was anticipated that the missile would be detected very late, and this would make intercepting Zircon almost impossible. But this clearly hasn't helped. Several sources have stated that the weight of the warhead inside the 3M22 Zircon is about 100 to 150 kilograms, of which 40 kilograms, or about 88 pounds, is the total weight of explosives. The type is the high explosive fragmentation variety, featuring a distinctly unconventional shape and notably lighter weight in comparison to standard anti-ship or other attack missiles. For reference, the Russian KH-47 Kinzhal ballistic missile has a warhead of 500 kilograms, while KH-101, KH-55, and Caliber cruise missiles have warheads of about 400 kilograms. While the kinetic energy is very high due to extreme speed, the small explosive power is its Achilles heel. The explosive power won't be enough to sink a decent-sized warship like the American Arleigh Burke-class destroyer or decimate a fortified land target. Some in Kremlin had indicated that the missile would be able to cripple an American supercarrier whose displacement reaches 100,000 tons. But as evident, this is far from the truth. Zircon is thought to cost about 3 times or 5 times compared to other similar missiles. This makes serial production in large quantities difficult. Siddharth Kaushal, research fellow at the Royal United States Institute in London, wrote last year after Admiral Gorshkov allegedly deployed with Zircons aboard, "A key consideration is Russia's ability to produce and field a capability like Zircon at scale, especially as the program will compete for financial and other resources with priorities like rebuilding the Russian ground forces." It's to be noted that several Russian platforms are suffering due to financial issues. For example, initial reports suggested that Kremlin will order as many as 2,300 Armada main battle tanks by 2020, but as evident, the tank is not combat ready, and only about a dozen have been built until now. Another example is Su-57. Kremlin originally planned to have 150 of these aircraft in service by 2020. Later, it was stated that a procurement plan is being laid out for acquiring 76 Su-57, and these jets are expected to be deployed by 2028. Given the high cost, it's possible that Zircon would be manufactured in very limited numbers, and this will reduce its impact in a war.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.